And what about the radioactivity? Next slide. We know from the historical radiological assessment and also the addenda to the remedial investigation that a whole suite of radioactive substances may have been or may still be present. They came from luminescent dials, from chip decontamination, from the research lab that was there for many years, from some experiments, and also in the sewer and storm drains. So that's the concern for radiation. Next. And here's what's proposed at this point to solve the problems of these contaminants. Either remove and dispose everything off-site, or cover it up. The details of the cover are yet to come if that's what's selected. And also institutional controls, meaning complying with a risk management plan that will be developed by the city and others subsequent to the remediation. Okay, next. In groundwater, the groundwater gets treated with these innovative techniques, which have shown a lot of promise. The groundwater has to be monitored to make sure nothing is migrating toward the bay where it would cause ecological damage. And again, institutional controls, such as no using the groundwater for irrigation or drinking. Next. The radiological plan is basically to survey everything that's suspect, decontaminate it if necessary, take it away if you have to, and make sure that the National Radiological Safety Office clears everything for unconditional release. Next. Okay, I took the liberty of revising a figure that the Navy put into their feasibility study, in which they try to rate the various alternatives. And the scores are keyed out down in the lower left. So a 1 is the highest and a 4 is the worst. It's like the final 4. You know, number 1 is better than number 4. So what about no action? Okay, that got several 4s. The 1s for the short-term effectiveness and implementability are kind of meaningless, because if you don't do anything, you're not having any short-term effects. Okay, so what about excavating and disposing? That's the best for long-term efficacy. It's not so good in cleaning it up by treatment, because you don't have to do any treatment. Okay, it's not good in the short term because of impacts to the community of trucking all this material away. And it might be difficult to implement, although we can come back to that later. And it's quite expensive. Then there are two possibilities, either containment, meaning a cover of some kind, after cleaning up the hotspots, and containment, hotspots, plus groundwater containment. And I'd like to mention that some of these alternatives were presented over the past couple of years. However, they didn't generally include number 3 and 4. The Navy has responded to community concerns about having a broader source of alternatives other than just containment or excavation. So I think these other alternatives are a step in the right direction. And all of the methods would have monitoring and institutional controls once they were completed. Okay, so next picture. Now, obviously, if we could excavate and dispose of everything, it would be like being in heaven. This isn't a Navy picture. Okay, now, to contrast a little bit, the next slide, please. Now, what about just covering it up? Are we just going to cover it up and leave it? I don't think so. I don't think that's a good idea. Okay, next. So how about containment plus hotspot removal? This looks pretty good, okay? But it's not all that realistic. Next slide. This is more like it, because it's not going to go back to paradise, as Espanola Jackson frequently reminds us this is a Superfund site, so there's going to have to be some kind of containment and treatment, and yet once it's cleaned up, we'll still be able to use the area. Next. And when the remediation is done, you can be sure that the area is going to be safe for residents and visitors, because all of the regulators and Archaeology and all of you are going to make sure that that's what happens before this process is over.